There is a God
who
is going to change your life.
You've
taken a lot of time in tears.
You've
gone through a lot of challenges.
You
don't stand away.
And
there is a God
agenda kutera
who is going to take the one in your life.
Wari wachikiriza kuwe hallelujah.
Someone to shout hallelujah.
Kankumbulire buri kimwe cyakukiriza.
If you don't have faith, nothing can change in your life. But let me tell you this, your life shall change in the name of Jesus. Let me prophesy this word.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Let me prophesy this. This church here that you see, you've not yet known this. Let me say it again. The church you see here that you see, you've not yet known the church. God is going to lift this church. Every person in this place shall be surprised. There are people who have been abusing this church. They speak ill about the church. And they are fighting against the church. Before April, you are going to see something that God is going to do in Genesis. Before you reach in April, you're going to see what is going to happen in this place. The thoughts of men unto this church are not the thoughts of God. But the thought of God is
what
shall be fulfilled in this I don't know
where
you're understanding this.
Ndabye ngasana koze sabando kurwanyise ekanise.
I saw the devil using people to fight this church.
No kono neri nyari
yayo. And tarnishing the name of Genesis. But I've seen God rising with His might power. I don't know for what reason. Many have reason to use witchcraft.
There's
something I thank God for. Whenever I reach in this place, there is prophecy that God gives me. And what I thank God for, there is no person who fellowships in this place that I meet. Anyone here I talk to on the phone? Your pastor, I spent like 5-4 months when I don't speak to him. From the other time I came in July, I saw him last Sunday
again.
This is the truth. I saw him when I'm together with my fiance. You were all there.
Nagamba na ye tukumissing.
Told him but we are missing you.
Mugamba na ye Sunday.
I told him but on Sunday.
Ochisabiri.
Pray for it.
Ngenda kuja.
I shall come.
Na ye kambaburi.
But let me tell you this. I have seen six people here
Mukama basindise
that God has sent.
Oba bantu, oba malaika simanyi.
I don't know whether the angels
okurwani de kanisa
to fight for the church.
Sumba.
Pastor's wife.
Ndaba mukama yakongera emyaka gyo kubeerawo.
I see God added more years to you.
Omwezi gw'omwenda n'ogwo kumi.
In September and October.
Waliwo omwoyo gw'okulumba gw'okufa.
There was a spirit of death.
Naye Katonda yakongera obulamu.
But God added more life. You shall live long. God has made you live longer. There are people who had bad plan until
now.
And among the people you hoped. But what they've done. I don't know where it starts from. But
now
God, I worship.
Christ,
there are no powers of darkness that shall sing a blessing unto your life. As I am speaking right now, you have a problem in your womb. But
that's
not one of these other issues of giving back. You don't have peace. But the God of heaven. It moves like a serpent inside. I've seen the angel of Jehovah.
He
speaks to you. The Holy Spirit tells me.
Let's give
us a mighty of praise for the life he has given to our pastor.
Saba mochitibga cho ogumikirizo semele wanoje.
I ask in your respect to kindly move.
Bawo mkwano gwanje. Ate na olisi, olisi, stogorichi.
And even you.
Na yeche manye olimukwano.
But I know a friend to me too.
Nse.
Me.
Sigenda kubuza nti byongyogera bitufu.
I shall not ask what I'm speaking. Because I believe.
Nti kyo kyongyogera kitufu.
What I'm speaking is right.
Oh. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Baba de baga.
They wanted you to die with a pregnancy, it failed.
Katonda nabeerawo.
And God was there for you.
Nsenkubulide ogenda kutandika kuwulira enkyuka.
You're going to start seeing a change in you. The devil has been putting a spirit of fear in you. You don't see any life ahead of you. You've been there worrying
all day.
Your joy of
returning.
You have no peace in your
heart.
The God of heaven.
The God of
your life. Even some of your shoes. There is something that you don't know. I believe some people don't know what is called death. If someone, if God has given life to someone, then you've not yet understood what God has meant. God has given you life in abundance. I see God setting your legs free. I saw them swelling abruptly. But I saw God setting you free. This is your time. The God of heavens. The God, creator of heavens and earth. The powerful God. The God of grace. The God of glory. The power on me. I just every kind of spirit of witchcraft and anything that has been fighting against her life, I pull out your name, whatever it has been. I pull out your photos, whatever they be, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I restore back your life. Never step again. She has taken time feeling things running her stomach. She would tell you about it. I have pain in everything. Today I slept when I'm still alive. I woke up turning to breastfeed my daughter. I felt pain. I told my husband, but I felt a lot of pain in my womb.
No, put on my umbrella.
Even then, put on shoes and pain. I said, if it was not prayer, I would have stayed and slept. I was seated over there, I was feeling pain. I thank God that I am not feeling this kind of pain. I surround the blood of Jesus. I surround you in the power of Jesus. The Holy Spirit may surround your entire life. Every woman, every witch was been fighting you. Everyone was been attacking you. In the name of Jesus, I separate from this kind of woman. Whatever they've been doing unto your life, let God bless you
abundantly.
Don't struggle again with this kind of sin. Jesus,
a mighty
hand of praise. Jesus, a mighty hand of praise. Jesus, a mighty hand of praise. Jesus, a mighty hand of praise. I was still prophesying unto the church. This is the time God has come out for Genesis.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let me tell you this. Every individual in this place, I was fighting for this
church.
The truth
agenda
shall not get this is what the God says. In the entire life, this person shall not get peace. I have told you this. This person shall not get peace. But what I see, the time has come. You may get the land for the church. There is someone in this space. You had people telling you, telling you what to take you out of this church. They were telling you that the time you spent in this kind of church, what have you ever gotten out? They are like four people here who have been listening to this kind of information. Can you believe and stand over this place? When you've ever found this kind of word, I may change your life. I'll not ask you who told you this and this. What I want is you to come over. I want two girls. One is in the choir. Someone remaining in the back, I will not speak before you come in front.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want to get someone from this other side. This person who has ever had this kind of word. Let me first tell you this. Every kind of voice that takes you out of this place, there is nothing good that this voice wishes you to have apart from making you suffer. This is why there is your blessing. If you get out, you go. Your blessing shall stay in this place. Come closer.
Instead of
the time you spent
praying.
First, think about the years they've been bewitching you. At times you're always in chains before knowing that you're in bondage.
You reach
a time of knowing that you're in bondage after taking years and years in bondage.
But
because of the grace of God, God reveals what is
happening
and reveals what has changed. You enter in the journey of deliverance. God is going to take out every shame that has been upon your life.
Family,
the family you're coming from is not an easy family. The things they've done are a lot. Even up to now, many are still
practicing.
But there is God. You hear me. I am speaking to you. There is God. Who is above? Above every powers that has chained you. You've been in bondage for over years. Everything of yours was
chained.
Everything was in chains.
But
there is the grace of
Jehovah.
It is coming upon you. But everything is whatever you touch is a loss. Whatever you heard of was in a loss. Every time you're working in a loss, you've done a lot. You've thought a lot. But you've not yet reached your dream. You've been put a lot of but everything is failing out. The years you've spent suffering is enough. Lift up your hands. There is no more loss. No more loss. Everything that I ever snatched from you, the Lord. But I see the grace of the Lord coming back. It is coming back to you. It is changing your life afresh. Whatever garment that was put on you, today it has to be put off your life. You're going to be set free completely. I see God taking all the bad kind of dreams that you've taken a time fighting
with.
You dream fighting.
There is no
fresh life that you're going to enter in. I see God healing your back.
Oh, boy,
yes. God, yeah. Every voice taking out of this church. Tell it, I'll not get out of this church. Because this is what is my victory.
Born
again. Gamba neighbor.
Tell your neighbor. That this is your day. I take out every bondage. Whatever is upon you, whatever was put upon your life, everything that has chained you, every power that has chained you, that is upon you, I command it. I take it out. I set your life free in the name of Jesus. I send fire in your life. I send fire in your life. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes,
Jesus.
Yes,
Jesus. Every spirit of loss, everything that has changed your life,
today
I command you to get out of your life.
Never
suffering,
never
tears,
in
the name of Jesus. Be set free. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
There
are some are seated in this place. I want to first talk to speak to this person, then I enter into the word. We shall prophesy again from the word. There is someone seated in this place. There are times you were pledging. This person pledged something in church. Something that she or she's going to do in the house of God. Time reached. What this person pledged did not fulfill it. But the reason I made this person not fulfill the pledge, there is someone who reached to him and had words to tell this person that prevented this person to fulfill the pledge. This person was just there confused, but not that in the sense that this person would not
pay.
There are things that made this person lose the hope, and this person did not fulfill the pledge. I kindly ask you, if you're hearing me and you're in this place, please lift up your hand. Raise up your hand wherever you're sitting.